burns!
Hey there, friends and neighbors. Welcome back to Myst TV. Be sure to hit like and subscribe if you haven't already, because today we're going to be delving into yet another edutainment-filled explanatory video on some of those vaping 101 issues. Now, has this ever happened to you? Yeah, I didn't find it was like that. No, back when I lived in Geneva, I found...
Oh God, it burns! Ah!
No, that's probably not happened to you, because frankly, the phenomenon known as spitback isn't actually all as dramatic as that. But we appreciate it's a pain in the butt and on the lips. So today we're gonna talk about how you can prevent spitback. Now, my previous dramatic reenactment aside, most people have actually experienced spitback at some point in their lives. Generally, it's more likely to have occurred to you if you're more drawn to the bulkier, more powerful, high wattage sub-ohm vapes. But lower wattage MTL machines, such as the Inokin Easy Watts, the Vaptio Ergo, it's not to say that this doesn't happen with those devices as well. It is an almost fairly universal issue, and it's not as unusual as you might think it is. Now, for those living in blissful ignorance, spitback refers to the phenomenon where hot beads of e-liquid fly out of the mouthpiece and hit either your lips or tongue. It's an unpleasant experience that generally carries the not nice 1-2 punch of being initially quite hot and then it numbs you for about 10 seconds in the spot where it hit. Now, there are no long-term health issues or any kind of consequences to this happening besides a momentary irritation. Whilst we appreciate that you do not want to be ingesting e-liquid, as nicotine is a toxic substance, a spot or two in the mouth is not going to hurt you. Now, 99% of the time, spitback is taking place because a large amount of e-liquid has begun to pool inside the coil or a reservoir has started to build up in the area just underneath it. As you may remember from a previous video of ours, coils are rather sophisticated and delicate mechanisms, only intended to vaporize the e-liquid which is being held in the absorbent materials around the heating element. Once liquid starts to get through those absorbent materials and pools around the Canthal wire or whatever other element is inside your personal coil, that's when you're going to start to see spitback taking place. You can see what happens when e-liquid comes into direct contact with an exposed heating element. Hot flecks of e-liquid start spitting off in every which way direction. Unfortunately, those directions do include towards your mouth. But fear not, fellow traveler, because there are many ways to prevent this from taking place. First things first, stop priming your coils so damn much. As you may remember from a previous video, we point out that there is a rather sensible way to prime your coil. That is to simply take your e-liquid and paint some of the exposed cottons rather gently with a thin layer of e-liquid so that it's already been introduced and when new e-liquid hits that tank, it can soak up nice and quickly. What you really want to stop doing is taking large globules of e-liquid and just dumping them straight into the top of your coil. Unless you're using an RDA, you really don't want to be doing that because yeah, you're going to save yourself a few minutes of soak time, but you are going to lose a few days of the coil and the days that you do have it are going to be a little bit spitty. If you think that there's some juice pooling inside the coil, one quick fix method that you can do just to sort of clear it out is to just take the device and with a good firm grip, give it a strong flick downwards, just a flick towards the ground. This inertia will usually force most of the collected e-liquid out of the drip tip and down towards the floor. If you've got a little bit more of a significant buildup, you might want to take a cotton bud or a bit of wadded up tissue paper, just take the top off of your tank, dab around the inside of the coil, and then probably, just to follow up, you're probably going to want to take that coil out of the tank and just dab around the inside of the coil's base, where, as we pointed out earlier, you probably now have a bit of a reservoir of e-liquid. Now, sometimes you're gonna get spit back or a buildup of e-liquid inside the coil because your coil's just on the way out. The cottons have become damn near caramelized from weeks of cooking sugary e-liquid and they're just not absorbent anymore. Liquid is seeping through the gaps, it's going through it, it's not getting soaked up, and it is unfortunately going to pool around the only place it has to go, which is right around the heating element in the center. In these situations, all you're gonna need to do is change your coil. Just take it apart, take the old coil out, but we do recommend still do a little bit of that interior cleanup. Cotton bud, bit of tissue paper, just dab, dab, dab on the inside just to prevent any ongoing buildup, because a few months down the line, you might find that that reservoir has become just a spit machine. So I would recommend whenever you're changing a coil, just give the inside of your tank a little bit of a clean. Now, the fact is that some vapes are simply more prone to spit back than others. Generally, it is more of a problem with your big chunky sub-ohmy kits like this, and it's because of a few things. You've got the increased wattage and increased power shooting into the coil. The coil is generally much wider, more wide open, with more exposed actual metal going around it. And then you've usually also got a wider mouthpiece, often something like this, an 810 size mouthpiece, which is generally considered wide bore, and it's gonna provide quite a large avenue for rogue specs to sort of flick upwards. Whilst you can experience this with mouth to lung kits, as we did previously mention, it does happen a lot less. And usually when that takes place, it's just an indication that the coil is on its way out. Whereas with a sub-ohm kit, it's not unusual to get a bit of spit now and then, even on a good healthy day for your coil. Now, there are mouthpieces out there with spit back in mind. These are often referred to as anti-spit or mouthpieces equipped with a spit shield. The spit shield will usually be a small mesh array or a kind of honeycomb dot pattern on the inside of the mouthpiece. If spit back is a real sticking issue for you, you might want to look into one of these, because those arrays will pretty much always catch any e-liquid that's shooting up towards them. However, if you are looking for a spit shield mouthpiece, you do want to take note as to whether you're using an 810 or 510 size mouthpiece, because they're not interchangeable, but those are the only two that are available. And generally speaking, it's probably going to be an 810, because as we said, this is usually an issue that occurs with a sub-ohming vape, which is far more likely to have an A10. We hope this has been another informative Mist TV lecture on a fairly common vaping happenstance. The fact is, new vapers can be flighty people. You've just given up smoking for what might have been a decades-long habit, and now you're running into physical pains and frustrations with a device that you maybe didn't even want in the first place. We've seen more than enough reasonably minded vapers run straight back into the arms of Mother Tobacco because of just a few momentary hurdles and setbacks, and we beseech thee, please stick to vaping. A momentary frustration or irritation is infinitely preferable to the kinds of health consequences that are almost inevitable if you continue smoking. And we'll be here for you every step of the way if you need any advice or you need any help finding something that's not gonna be spitting into your mouth. Trust me, it's better than smoking. We hope you've enjoyed this one, guys. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Ciao.